Ladies and gentlemen, this is the WBA Lightweight Championship of the World. Please welcome now the challenger, the fighting pride of Manchester, Anthony Million Dollar Crawler.
I've been walking in the same way as I do.
The big smile and the reception is going to be rapturous.
Is there anything I can do for you, dear? Is there
He celebrated his 29th birthday this week.
Thank you, please, my
and he must have thought he's long overdue a special present. Last Christmas was ruined after the Have a Go Hero clash with burglars left him fighting for his very future. And in July he was back here, a major underdog, but he came of age, raised his game, and was desperately unlucky not to be crowned the new world lightweight king. Boxing's not sentimental, Glenn, it can be cruel, but he's got to rise all over again. He has the rematch, he has this support. Can he get it right on another massive night for Manchester boxing?
Adam, you're right, boxing can be cruel, but I tell you what, does he look like a man that boxing's been cruel to? He's enjoying every moment of this. He didn't get it the first time. He's got another chance to prove that he's world class, that he's a world champion. And it couldn't happen to a nicer guy. He's got it here in Manchester. He's hometown in a rapturous affair. I mean, the people are going mad here. It is wonderful to see. Would you believe this 2 years ago?
Now, ladies and gentlemen, time to welcome the champion from Colombia, Darlis Perez.
From the dusty streets of San Pedro de Arapa in the north of Colombia, once more to Manchester comes the experienced 32-year-old 9-stone-9 champion Darlis Perez, a former top draw amateur, a representative in 2 world championships in the Beijing Olympics. He's won 32 of 34. Last time he was a hot favorite, but his fizzle went rather flat. Low blows and a disjointed performance. Is he better than he showed in July?
Well, he's going to have to show a bit more than that. He's never really had that world-class performance that we thought he had in him. So, is he going to pull it out now?
Introducing the challenger, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing white and gold with purple trim, on the scales, 9 stone, 8 pounds, 8 ounces. Brings to the ring a 36 fight record, 29 wins, 11 inside the scheduled distance, only 4 defeats, 3 draws. The former English champion, former British champion, former WBO Intercontinental champion. Tonight, he is the challenger, the fighting pride of Manchester, England, Anthony Million Dollar Crawler. And across the ring stands the champion, Damas y Caballeros, El Campeón del Mundo, wearing sparkling silver and black, weighing in at 9 stone, 8 pounds. From 34 contests, 32 wins, 20 inside the scheduled distance, 1 defeat, 1 draw. He is the reigning WBA lightweight champion of the world from San Pedro de Arapa, Colombia, Darlis Perez.
Your gentle spot, you're in the change room, you know what I expect. Shake hands, best of luck, God bless you both.
A super 50-50 Pick'em rematch after their controversial draw here 4 months ago. The WBA 9-stone-9 champion, Darlys Perez, defending his belt. Anthony Crawler challenging all over again. It's a clean slate. Is it round 13?
Round one.
Or would you prefer it to be round one, Glenn? Both camps, both tactics.
Well, you know, they know each other so well. We know them so well. I think what we had was a very good fight the first time, and we're going to get that again. Who can do something different? That's the big question. Who can turn it up a little bit, because that's what it's going to take.
Will it be the fairy tale ending to a fairly nightmarish year for Anthony Crawler, or will Darlys Perez prove he is indeed the real ruler? He blamed bad preparation last time out, an allergy to pepper that he had in some food over here. He said he felt poor on the night and terrible afterwards, dehydrated, but take nothing away from Crawler's performance. He established that jab early, which was a key weapon. He hurt him in the second round, and he seemed just to improve session by session, Glenn. The confidence, everything about the whole sort of armory that Anthony Crawler possessed through the fight, mentally, physically. It was a terrific performance.
Yeah, it was. It really was. It was something, you know, he just looked like he'd risen above anything he'd ever done, as if, you know, what he'd been through, and as if everything that was getting snatched away he had back, and he was just so grateful that he went for it with everything he had. And you know, already he's the first one to land. There was a nice little left hand and left hook. Perez hasn't come out oozing confidence or looking razor sharp in the first round.
So prestigious amateur Darlys Perez, and only one defeat on the professional slate. He's the man from a tough area of Colombia. He loves to fight, and he felt he let himself down last time, although he believed it was really close. Got out with a draw. He's come back. Right hand just whistles past from Crawler. Combination from Perez. Both trying to hold center ring. And you can just feel the intensity around what was an electric atmosphere when Crawler came in, wasn't it?
Yeah, it really was. I mean, I think people have really grown to him. You know, what he's been through, knowing that he's a hero outside the ring. And I mean, he looks likely to be a hero inside the ring in the last fight. But he's got a chance again.
Good jab from Perez, strong and forceful. And again, both trying to get that upper hand early.
Yeah, he didn't really do anything the last 20 seconds, though, Perez, when he landed a couple of shots. Good start from Crawler. I'd be happy with that.
Good opener. Did Crawler nick it? Perez did well late on. It's a really good time for boxing. Next week is massive. The tactics, Klitschko Fury, that's our offering on Monday night. Tuesday and Wednesday, we go behind the ropes into the scenes of the camps. Vladimir Klitschko Tuesday, Tyson Fury Wednesday. Don't miss those. We decamp to Dusseldorf for countdowns on Thursday and on Friday. Saturday is the special event on Sky Sports Box Office. We get underway at 7 o'clock. The world heavyweight title, the unbeaten Tyson Fury. Can he do it, or will Klitschko continue his reign? It is mouthwatering, Glenn, and you'll be there.
We certainly will. What a place to be. It's going to be fantastic.
Tonight, it was Hanover or Manchester, two world title fights. Martin Murray, unlucky out there. Can Anthony Crawler become the next world champion for Britain? Our Congratulations to Lee Haskins as well, who didn't get the fight against Randy Caballero, but has been made a world champion again. British boxing's booming. Can Crawler pick up from that and deliver another top-notch performance?
Well, it's in his hands. The build-up, he says, has been excellent. They're very, very confident. They've done everything that has been expected of them moving into this fight. Sparring's gone well, so I think, you know, he's just got to give it everything. You have to in a world title fight. Didn't quite give enough last time, the judges felt. So this time, he knows he's got to take it into his own hands and really work out this win.
Good right hand to the body from Perez. Crawler, who's been sparring with Stephen Smith and Scott Quigg, who's in his corner tonight for speed, and Zelfa Barrett, Pat Barrett's nephew as well, for the awkwardness of Perez. But Perez told me he's had a terrific training camp at home in Barranquilla in Colombia. They normally go to LA, they didn't. He stayed home and he said it has been perfect. It's a really tight start, isn't it? Both of them finding punches early. And the battle is brewing already.
I would have thought Perez would have gotten better work out in LA with the guys out there in the busy gym than he would have gotten in Barranquilla in Colombia, but I don't know who they brought in.
Crawler getting his defense up. I think the plan was to throw a few more punches, just keep the combinations going. Try and get on top of Perez. Good left hand from Perez. He looks a bit tighter and cuter. And physically so strong as well. They know each other, these two. There's no search party, is there? They're no. Right in the middle of the ring.
No, in the boxing from the middle of the ring. Crawler tried to hunt him down last time. Didn't get many times in and out of range. Hasn't got a state in range that often, which is where Perez can be dangerous, can pick off good shots there. But that's good there from Crawler. Nice work with the jab.
Yep, utilized that well. Perez came back looking for the body shot as well. That's good from Crawler, though. Accuracy with the jab, timing. He says he's expected a better Perez, but that he is better Crawler. From the time in the gym, that he will prove he's come on tonight. Tit for tat. Did Perez take that one? It's close this already.
Boxing well, standing there.
There is Joe Gallagher, one of the hottest trainers in boxing at the moment, after Callum Smith's one-round demolition the other night against Rocky Fielding. Callum and all the Smith brothers here to support their man, Mr. Crawler. How's he begun for you?
Yeah, he's begun pretty well. Certainly won the first round for me, Perez the second. But there's nothing in it at the minute.
The silver and black of Darlis Perez, the 32-year-old from Colombia in fight number 35. And the white, gold and purple of Anthony Crawler from New Moston in Manchester. And I don't think it's just about the last year where people have warmed to him. I think it's been his story. He's had to overcome hurdles and bumps and people sort of dismissing him when he lost to Derry Matthews. He's come right back. Yeah, that great win over John Murray. People love an underdog that comes through, don't they?
Yeah, he's come through, you know what? But he's always come through as well with a smile. Such a pleasant, nice man outside of the ring. You know, and I think people, you can't help but warm to him, can you?
Yeah, he's a smashing chap, he really is. I was talking to his good lady Fran at the weigh-in, and there's obviously nerves in the family, but she's ringside tonight. And we'll be watching as intensely as Anthony is concentrating. Whereas for Perez, he has four kids back in Colombia. He said they're mouths to feed. I need to keep this world title and keep earning big. But it's about a revenge thing as well for him, I think, Perez. I think he felt he let himself and his team down a bit last time.
Yeah, I think he didn't get off to such a great start. He was countering a little bit too much. He's looking to be a little more dominant as he's come out here, but he's still a little bit loose. The hands are down. There's gaps there.
Trying to work the body, get that left hand moving. Perez, certainly more confident, more poised about him, but he is taking the odd risk as well.
Yeah, he's making mistakes as he comes forward. He's not landing with anything.
Body shots from Crawler, good defence as well from the Manchester man. Digging in the uppercuts, Perez. This is going to be a really grueling one, you sense already. It's been laid out. We're only in the third round. The pace is going to be white hot.
Oh, good defensive work from Crawler there. Been a little open in this round. Perez, good jabs again from Crawler. He's kept his boxing well. Worked head and body, Anthony Crawler, and that's nice.
Yeah, that jab as well landing. Not everything getting through from either man. Just a bit more from Crawler, you sense here in the third. Good fight.
Okay. Boxing well, all right. Just letting him touch too much. A couple of things we've worked on training. Right hand, you got to roll your head after it. Right hand to the body, you're out of range. Right hand body, come up left foot to the head. All right, okay? Just little things getting caught with. And also, you're just getting into that rhythm where you're stepping back and stepping in. So it's timing as you're coming in. Step back, pause, and then come back in, all right? Okay? You're just coming back in, back in. It's just timing and timing you. Roll your head after the right hand, leaving it out and getting caught, okay?
Very knowledgeable corner, but he's pretty knowledgeable about the game and the history as well, Anthony Crawler. He loves talking about the old fights and the modern fights. Good guy to be around, isn't he?
Yeah, he really is. And he started this well, I think. Got the better defence, keep nice and tight, getting better work with the jab. And the one thing I'm noticing is, in the first fight, with the reputation he came out, you know, I was expecting to see a superstar, and then Crawler did so well, and we thought maybe Perez hadn't worked that hard. Again, looking at this early on, I don't think, you know, Perez is unbeatable. I think Crawler can win this if he does it right.
I think he really believes in himself now, Anthony Crawler, as well. He was very dignified to accept the draw. No massive complaints in the ring or in the post-fight interview afterwards. That's just not in his nature. But as for Darlis Perez, he's been a perfect gentleman this week. Watched him work out on Tuesday and thought he looked really sharp, comfortable at the weight. And he is the only world champion in Colombia at the moment. It means a great deal to him and his people. He's come with a good team. Left nothing to chance. This crowd starting to get behind Anthony Crawler, whose work rate is good, but Perez still throwing out plenty of leather here in the fourth.
Yeah, it's one of those fights where he's going to have to tough it out, Crawler. He's going to have to show great character, great resolve, come through some tough patches. He's going to have to want it more than Perez.
Might come down to defense here, Glenn, and how many of the shots creep through, how many are accurate. That was a good body shot from Crawler, and the three judges at ringside, what they favor, what they're seeing round by round.
Yeah, Crawler has got to tug up, he's got to keep using good head movement, which he started off with, and Perez misses quite a lot, and that's going to tire the Colombian out as Crawler comes back with a good spell.
Yeah, working the body, trying the uppercut, driving it through the middle. His big hero was Ricky Hatton. He used to sit up here in the gods watching his man when he was a kid, Anthony Crawler. He never believed he'd be topping a night like this. You looked round beforehand, Glenn, you couldn't believe it, could you?
No, fantastic. I mean, he really has risen up to star level, and that's great to see for somebody who deserves it as much. Having a good round here, though. He's making Perez miss a lot, and he's landed with some good shots.
Bit of blood to the Crawler nose. A hard round, but haven't they all been so far? I wonder if something will give at some point. because Terry O'Connor is just watching it like we are. Perez swinging and missing. Good body shot from Crawler. Hurt him there, just momentarily at the end of the round. Just troubled him with a body shot, I felt, at the end of the fourth, Glenn.
Yeah, but look at the way he was getting through them. Good uppercuts. He's covering up nice, getting through a body shot there. Then he makes Perez miss. And it's that sort of work that might make Perez come apart a little bit. He was getting a bit wild towards the end of that round, getting frustrated that he wasn't landing.
Here's the fifth, the 192nd of Dalys Perez's career, which began in 2009. It is the 220th for Anthony Crawler, who started 9 years ago. So he's probably got more experience in a funny sort of way, although Dalys Perez is the world champion. Crawler, the improver from New Mostyn, and Perez remaining the champion for now. He defended it in July. Can he do it again here? Break Manchester hearts. Good work from Crawler, backing Perez up. I think he wants to really turn the heat up on the Colombian tonight.
Yeah, well, I think he has to break his heart as well if he's gonna take this title. It's gonna have to be another inspired performance from Anthony Crawler. And so far, he's fitting the bill.
There's not enough movement, really, from Perez. With the feet, he's just standing there with Crawler. Crawler's just a little lighter on his toes, in and out of range.
He caught with a couple of silly ones in this round, Crawler.
But he's looking for the big shot, isn't he, Perez? A lot.
Yeah, he's trying to wind punches up. And I think that's maybe a little sign of frustration. You know, the fact that Crawler's defense is good, that he's coming forward, that it's a lot like the first fight. Straight away, Crawler's in the groove, and Perez not having it the way he wanted it.
Every time he lands, or even partially lands, he gets the big cheer of the crowd. We heard that with Arthur Abraham against Martin Murray a few minutes ago, that every time Abraham lands, the crowd. Does that affect the judges even subconsciously? He has the home advantage, and he has a wonderful body shot. Anthony Crawler, I'm not sure he's going to make it. I think he's going to be knocked out here. It is over. Anthony Million Dollar Crawler has the dream night, the fairy tale ending. One of the nicest guys in British boxing. Life and the crowd go wild. Manchester Crawler, what a knockout!
Fairy tales do come true sometimes, and he really deserves it. And look at what it means to him. He's finally, he's world champion in Manchester.
As a young boy, he watched from the rafters as Ricky Hatton demolished his opposition with body shots. And I tell you what, wherever Ricky is tonight, he will be so mightily proud of what Anthony Crawler just did. It was toe-to-toe for 4.5 rounds. And I tell you what, that body shot, he's never thrown a better one.
No, and it just shows, you know, the intensity that he was putting on. His jab was working all the time. I was just about to say the jab is key in this fight because it was working so well. And then he just whipped down something unexpected and got in a beautiful body punch with the left hand. Took everything out of Perez. We didn't expect it, but most certainly he didn't expect it. And it took everything away from him.
Anthony Crawler goes over to the Colombian corner as the crowd celebrates. That is the first stoppage defeat for Dalys Perez, who loses his world title. It's changed hands. Britain has a new lightweight king to go alongside Terry Flanagan, and look at this.
Perfect. working to the head, and he shook his head straight away. He knew straight away that that was too hard and he couldn't take that. Teasers to the head, teasers to the head, but look how accurate he is when he sees that that spot open up. He's straight in there.
He knew, didn't he?
Right, as soon as that shot connected, he knew that was the finish.
The shake of the head and the delivery of a left hook, but it wasn't just that. Anthony Crawler had been on him from the opening bell. Dolis Perez trying to stay with him, and he couldn't take that one.
There, he's feeding to the head, his arms are coming up, and then quick as a flash, he sees that gap. That was great reflexes, great time, and he knew exactly what he had to do. Picked the punch perfectly, and he is now the champion of the world.
He gets the $1 million prize, the world title. Money won't mean a thing for Anthony Crawler. It is that moment of magic. Joe Gallagher and Anthony Crawler get it spot on. And nice guys do come first at times.
Yep, well, they have there. Look what it means to him. All he's been through. He's a hero outside of the ring, and now a hero inside of the ring. Well done, Anthony Crawler.
It's a wonderful story. The have-a-go hero, who almost did it in the summer, finally delivers, and emphatically, in style, in front of his people. What a night here in Manchester. And poor Dolis Perez, who came to retain his belt, loses out. Great respect between the pair, though.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 2 minutes 30 seconds of round number 5. Terry O'Connor reaches the count of 10. The winner by count out, and the new WBA lightweight champion of the world, the Fighting Pride of Manchester, Anthony $1 million Crawler.
Anthony, congratulations. Yeah. Anthony Crawler, WBA lightweight champion of the world. How does that sound to you?
Honest, Ed, I've dreamt this dream since I was 10 years of age, and I didn't know it was this good, honestly. It's even better than I dreamt.
So much delight on your face, and what a way to finish it with a body shot, one punch knockout.
Yeah, I believe that I'm getting stronger all the time, but I thought it was going to be an headshot. I was really confident that I was going to get Dolis Perez out of there, but I thought it'd be an headshot, but listen, I'd take that body shot any day of the week.
The perfect shot. Tell us how you set it up.
I'll have to watch it back. Me, I can't remember anything, but I remember touching up top with the right and then sinking the left in downstairs. And like most people, when they land a good body shot, I knew it was over there and then.
Why was it so different second time around? Because obviously the first fight was a cagey affair and it was very close.
I just went away and I worked hard on the team. And Joel told me exactly what I had to work on. And we've worked so hard in the gym, and you know, I don't know. I've just got to thank, like you say, the team around me. Joe, he's turned my career around. Honest to God, a lot of people have given up on me when I went to him, and I'm just so thankful to have this world title shot and take it like this.
Real team effort, but you are champion.
Yeah.
What an incredible feeling.
It's an amazing feeling. It's a dream come true. Before I go any further, can I just say, there's a young lad called James Barrett who was a fan of mine, and during the build-up, during the training camp of this, he lost his battle with cancer, though. That's in memory of James Barrett.
Just another thing to spur you on the biggest night of your career.
Yeah, definitely. Listen, this is a dream come true now, and now I just want many more nights like this in Manchester. They come out and I'll be forever in debt to these people.
I know you've always been a boxing fan. Your father was a fighter as well.
Yeah.
You must have dreamt of nights like this with an atmosphere like this when you saw the Ricky Hatton days of old.
Honestly, I've come to this arena saving my pocket money since I was 10 years old, watching Nazim Ahmed, your Michael Brody's, Joe Calzaghe's, and obviously our very own Ricky Hatton for many of his big nights. So to win a world title in this arena, there's nowhere else I'd rather do it.
And how incredible for Manchester, they've got two lightweight champions of the world, yeah, with Terry Flanagan as well. Is that a fight you'd be interested in the
yeah,
future?
Certainly. Listen, me and Terry, we've got a lot of respect for each other. We've got massive respect for his team. And listen, if politics can be put aside, then it's a great night for Manchester, then I wouldn't have a problem with it. I'm sure he wouldn't. But the man with the plan, whoever it is, tell me to fight, I'll fight, honestly.
I know it was a team effort. Let's have a word with your trainer, Joe Gallagher. Anthony was very thankful of you there. How proud are you of him this evening?
Very proud. The kid, listen, when he came to me, he'd lost. And he's had his ups and downs. He's an absolutely shining example for professionals out there that have setbacks in the career, but don't give up through hard work, dedication. And for him to achieve his dream tonight in front of this crowd there in Manchester Arena, got to say huge thanks to Eddie Hearn and the WBA for making the rematch. And it was an opportunity we got to grab with both hands, and Anthony went in there. I said beforehand we needed the nasty Anthony Crawler, and he was there tonight.
Was he punch perfect?
No, we can be better. There's no room for improvement. Don't let the grass go under our feet. But I want to say thank you to the crowd for coming out, supporting Anthony tonight. And hopefully next summer, we might see Anthony Crawler fight at Old Trafford.
Well, that would be incredible. Eddie, what are the plans going forward with Anthony?
Well, we're going to have a few beers tonight, Ed. And Manchester's going to celebrate a new world champion. That's the first thing. But, you know, I'm so pleased for him, because the worry was for the second time round, can you grab the opportunity? I'm not sure you could find a nicer man in the world, let alone boxing, than Anthony Crawler. Everyone that knows Anthony Crawler was just begging and praying that he could deliver tonight. But to deliver like that, Manchester, Britain should be so proud of Anthony Crawler, because he's just an advocate of the phrase, never give up. I saw him losing Prize Fighter, you know, like 2 years ago. We built him back, he came back, but he's worked so hard with Joe Gallagher. Anthony Crawler is the new world lightweight champion. It's unbelievable, I'm so proud of him. And now we're going to go on and have some mega fights that are going to change his life forever.
Anthony, after everything you've been through, all the ups and the downs and a few defeats and real setbacks, and obviously what happened with you regarding that burglary, does that make this all the sweeter?
Yeah, this makes it all worth it. Honestly, I've had an absolute rollercoaster over the last 12 months, and this is just the perfect finish to it. And honestly, I can't thank this crowd that's turned out tonight and the team around me for delivering me this shot. It's just a dream come true.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the WBA Lightweight Championship of the World. Please welcome now the challenger, the fighting pride of Manchester, Anthony Million Dollar Crawler.
The big smile and the reception is going to be rapturous. He celebrated his 29th birthday this week, and he must have thought he's long overdue a special present. Last Christmas was ruined after the Have a Go Hero clash with burglars left him fighting for his very future. And in July he was back here, a major underdog, but he came of age, raised his game, and was desperately unlucky not to be crowned the new world lightweight king. Boxing's not sentimental, Glenn, it can be cruel, but he's got to rise all over again. He has the rematch, he has this support. Can he get it right on another massive night for Manchester boxing?
Adam, you're right, boxing can be cruel, but I tell you what, does he look like a man that boxing's been cruel to? He's enjoying every moment of this. He didn't get it the first time. He's got another chance to prove that he's world class, that he's a world champion. And it couldn't happen to a nicer guy. He's got it here in Manchester, his hometown, in a rapture a rapturous affair. I mean, the people are going mad here. It is wonderful to see. Would you believe this 2 years ago?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, time to welcome the champion from Colombia, Darlys Perez.
From the dusty streets of San Pedro de Arapa in the north of Colombia, once more to Manchester comes the experienced 32-year-old 9-stone-9 champion Darlys Perez, a former top draw amateur. A representative in two world championships in the Beijing Olympics. He's won 32 of 34. Last time he was a hot favourite, but his fizzle went rather flat. Low blows and a disjointed performance. Is he better than he showed in July?
Well, he's going to have to show a bit more than that. He's never really had that world-class performance that we thought he had in him. So, is he going to pull it out now?
Introducing the challenger, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing white and gold with purple trim, on the scales, 9 stone, 8 pounds, 8 ounces. Brings to the ring a 36 fight record, 29 wins, 11 inside the scheduled distance, only 4 defeats, 3 draws. The former English champion, former British champion, former WBO Intercontinental champion. Tonight, he is the challenger, the fighting pride of Manchester, England, Anthony Million Dollar And across the ring stands the champion, Damas y Caballeros, El Campeón del Mundo, wearing sparkling silver and black, weighing in at 9 stone, 8 pounds. From 34 contests, 32 wins, 20 inside the scheduled distance, 1 defeat, 1 draw. He is the reigning WBA lightweight champion of the world, from San Pedro de Arapa, Colombia, Darlys Perez.
Your gentle spot, you're in the changing room, you know what I expect. Shake hands, best of luck, God bless you both.
A super fit in this round, Perez, good jabs again from Crawler. He's kept his boxing well. Worked head and body, Anthony Crawlin, that's nice. Yeah, that jab as well landing. Not everything getting through from either man. Just a bit more from Crawler, you sense here in the third. Good fight.
Okay. Big breath. Okay. Boxing well, all right. Just letting him touch too much. A couple of things we've worked on training. Right hand, you got to roll your head after it. Right hand to the body, you're out of range. Right hand body, come up, left foot to the head. All right, okay? Just little things getting caught with. And also, you're just getting into that rhythm where you're stepping back and stepping in. So it's timing as you're coming in. Step back, pause, and then come back in, all right? Okay? You're just coming back in, back in. It's just timing and timing you. Roll your head after the right hand, leaving it out and getting caught, okay?
Very knowledgeable corner. But he's pretty knowledgeable about the game and the history as well, Anthony Crawler. He loves talking about the old fights and the modern fights. Good guy to be around, isn't he?
Yeah, he really is. And he started this well, I think. Got the better defense, keep nice and tight, and better work with the jab. And the one thing I'm noticing is, in the first fight, with the reputation he came out, you know, I was expecting to see a superstar. and then Crawler did so well, and we thought maybe Perez hadn't worked that hard. Again, looking at this early on, I don't think, you know, Perez is unbeatable. I think Crawler can win this if he does it right.
I think he really believes in himself now, Anthony Crawler, as well. He was very dignified to accept the draw. No massive complaints in the ring or in the post-fight interview afterwards. That's just not in his nature. But as for Darlis Perez, he's been a perfect gentleman this week. Watched him work out on Tuesday and thought he looked really sharp, comfortable at the weight. And he is the only world champion in Colombia at the moment. It means a great deal to him and his people. He's come with a good team. Left nothing to chance. This crowd starting to get behind Anthony Crawler, whose work rate is good, but Perez still throwing out plenty of leather here in the fourth.
Yeah, it's one of those fights where he's going to have to tough it out, Crawler. He's going to have to show great character, great resolve, come through some tough patches. He's going to have to want it more than Perez.
Might come down to defense here, Glenn, and how many of the shots creep through, how many are accurate. That was a good body shot from Crawler, and the three judges at ringside, what they favor, what they're seeing round by round.
Yeah, Crawler has got to tug up, he's got to keep using good head movement, which he started off with, and Perez misses quite a lot, and that's going to tire the Colombian out as Crawler comes back with a good spell.
Yeah, working the body, trying the uppercut, driving it through the middle. His big hero was Ricky Hatton. He used to sit up here in the gods watching his man when he was a kid, Anthony Crawler. He never believed he'd be topping a night like this. You looked round beforehand, Glenn, you couldn't believe it, could you?
No, fantastic. I mean, he really has risen up to star level, and that's great to see for somebody who deserves it as much. Having a good round here, though. He's making Perez miss a lot, and he's landed with some good shots.
Bit of blood to the Crawler nose. A hard round, but haven't they all been so far? I wonder if something will give at some point, because Terry O'Connor is just watching it like we are. Perez swinging and missing. Good body shot from Crawler. Hurt him there, just momentarily at the end of the round. Just troubled him with a body shot, I felt, at the end of the fourth, Glenn.
Yeah, but look at the way he was getting through them good uppercuts. He's covering up nice, getting through a body shot there. Then he makes Perez miss. And it's that sort of work that might make Perez come apart a little bit. He was getting a bit wild towards the end of that round, getting frustrated that he wasn't landing.
Here's the fifth, the 192nd of Darlis Perez's career, which began in 2009. It is the 220th for Anthony Crawler, who started 9 years ago. So he's probably got more experience in a funny sort of way, although Darlis Perez is the world champion. Crawler, the improver. 50-50 pick'em rematch after their controversial draw here 4 months ago. The WBA 9-stone-9 champion Darlis Perez defending his belt. Anthony Crawler challenging all over again. It's a clean slate. Is it round 13?
Round one.
Or would you prefer it to be round one, Glenn? Both camps, both tactics.
Well, you know, they know each other so well. We know them so well. I think what we had was a very good fight the first time, and we're going to get that again. Who can do something different? That's the big question. Who can turn it up a little bit? Because that's what it's going to take.
Will it be the fairy tale ending to a fairly nightmarish year for Anthony Crawler, or will Darlis Perez prove he is indeed the real ruler? He blamed bad preparation last time out, an allergy to pepper that he had in some food over here. He said he felt poor on the night and terrible afterwards, dehydrated, but take nothing away from Crawler's performance. He established that jab early, which was a key weapon. He hurt him in the second round, and he seemed just to improve session by session, Glenn. The confidence, everything about the whole sort of armory that Anthony Crawler possessed through the fight, mentally, physically. It was a terrific performance.
Yeah, it was, it really was. It was something, you know, he just looked like he'd risen above anything he'd ever done, as if, you know, what he'd been through, and as if everything that was getting snatched away he had back, and he was just so grateful that he went for it with everything he had. And you know, already he's the first one to land. There was a nice little left hand and left hook. Perez hasn't come out oozing confidence or looking razor sharp in the first round.
So, prestigious amateur Darlys Perez, and only one defeat on the professional slate. He's the man from a tough area of Colombia. He loves to fight, and he felt he let himself down last time, although he believed it was really close. Got out with a draw. He's come back. Right hand just whistles past from Crawler. Combination from Perez, both trying to hold center ring. And you could just feel the intensity around what was electric atmosphere when Crawler came in, wasn't it?
Yeah, it really was. I mean, I think people have really grown to him, you know, what he's been through, knowing that he's a hero outside the ring. And I mean, he looks likely to be a hero inside the ring in the last fight, but he's got a chance again.
Good jab from Perez, strong and forceful. And again, both trying to get that upper hand early.
Yeah, he didn't really do anything in the last 20 seconds, though, Perez, when he landed a couple of shots. Good start from Crawler. I'd be happy with that.
Good opener. Did Crawler nick it? Perez did well late on. It's a really good time for boxing. Next week is massive. The Tactics Klitschko Fury, that's our offering on Monday night. Tuesday and Wednesday, we go behind the ropes into the scenes of the camps. Vladimir Klitschko Tuesday, Tyson Fury Wednesday. Don't miss those. We decamp to Dusseldorf for countdowns on Thursday and on Friday. Saturday is the special event on Sky Sports Box Office. We get underway at 7 o'clock. The world heavyweight title, the unbeaten Tyson Fury. Can he do it, or will Klitschko continue his reign? It is mouthwatering, Glenn, and you'll be there.
We certainly will. And what a place to be. It's going to be fantastic.
Tonight, it was Hanover or Manchester, two world title fights. Martin Murray, unlucky out there. Can Anthony Crawler become the next world champion for Britain? Congratulations to Lee Haskins as well, who didn't get the fight against Randy Caballero, but has been made a world champion again. British boxing's booming. Can Crawler pick up from that and deliver another top-notch performance?
Well, it's in his hands. The build-up, he says, has been excellent. They're very, very confident. They've done everything that has been expected of them moving into this fight. Sparring's gone well, so I think, you know, he's just got to give it everything. You have to in a world title fight. Didn't quite give enough last time, the judges felt. So this time,
from New Boston, and Perez remaining the champion for now. He defended it in July. Can he do it again here? Break Manchester hearts. Good work from Crawler, backing Perez up. I think he wants to really turn the heat up on the Colombian tonight.
Yeah, well, I think he has to break his heart as well if he's gonna take this title. It's gonna have to be another inspired performance from Anthony Crawler. And so far, he's fitting the bill.
There's not enough movement, really, from Perez with the feet. He's just standing there with Crawler. Crawler's just a little lighter on his toes, in and out of range.
He caught with a couple of silly ones in this round, Crawler.
But he's looking for the big shot, isn't he, Perez? A lot.
Yeah, he's trying to wind punches up.
And I think that's maybe a little sign of frustration. You know, the fact that Cuellar's defence is good, that he's coming forward, that it's a lot like the first fight. Straight away, Cuellar's in the groove, and Perez not having it the way he wanted it.
Every time he lands, or even partially lands, he gets the big cheer of the crowd. We heard that with Arthur Abraham against Martin Murray a few minutes ago, that every time Abraham lands, the crowd, does that affect the judges even subconsciously? He has the home advantage, and he has a wonderful body shot. Anthony Cuellar, I'm not sure he's going to make it. I think he's going to be knocked out here. It is over. Anthony Million Dollar Cuellar has the dream night, the fairy tale ending. One of the nicest guys in British boxing has the night of his life. And the crowd go wild. Manchester Cuellar, what a knockout.
Fairy tales do come true sometimes, and he really deserves it. And look at what it means to him. He's finally, he's world champion in Manchester.
As a young boy, he watched from the rafters as Ricky Hatton demolished his opposition with body shots. And I tell you what, wherever Ricky is tonight, he will be so mightily proud of what Anthony Cuellar just did. It was toe-to-toe for 4.5 rounds, and I tell you what, that body shot, he's never thrown a better one.
No, and it just shows, you know, the intensity that he was putting on. His jab was working all the time. I was just about to say the jab is key in this fight because it was working so well. And then he just whipped down something unexpected and got in a beautiful body punch with the left hand. Took everything out of Perez. We didn't expect it, but most certainly he didn't expect it. And it took everything away from him.
Anthony Cuellar goes over to the Colombian corner as the crowd celebrate. That is the first stoppage defeat for Darlis Perez, who loses his world title. It's changed hands. Britain has a new lightweight king to go alongside Terry Flanagan, and look at this.
Perfect. Good work into the head, and he shook his head straight away. He knew straight away that that was too hard and he couldn't take that. Teasers to the head, teasers to the head, but look how accurate he is when he sees that spot open up. He's straight in there.
He knew, didn't he?
Right, as soon as that shot connected, he knew that was the finish.
The shake of the head and the delivery of a left hook, but it wasn't just that. Anthony Cuellar had been on him from the opening bell. Darlis Perez trying to stay with him, and he couldn't take that one.
There, he's feeding to the head. His arms are coming up, and then quick as a flash, he sees that gap. That was great reflexes, great time, and he knew exactly what he had to do. Picked the punch perfectly. And he is now the champion of the world.
He gets the million-dollar prize, the world title. Money won't mean a thing for Anthony Cuellar. It is that moment of magic. Joe Gallagher and Anthony Cuellar get it spot on. And nice guys do come first at times.
Yep, he knows he's got to take it into his own hands and really work out this win.
Good right hand to the body from Perez. Cuellar, who's been sparring with Stephen Smith, and Scott Quigg, who's in his corner tonight for speed, and Zelfa Barrett, Pat Barrett's nephew as well, for the awkwardness of Perez. But Perez told me he's had a terrific training camp at home in Barranquilla in Colombia. They normally go to LA, they didn't. He stayed home, and he said it has been perfect. It's a really tight start, isn't it? Both of them finding punches early, and the battle is brewing already.
I would have thought Perez would have gotten better work out in LA with the guys out there in the busy gym than he would have gotten in Barranquilla. in Colombia, but I don't know who they brought in.
Crawler getting his defense up. I think the plan was to throw a few more punches, just keep the combinations going. Try and get on top of Perez. Good left hand from Perez. He looks a bit tighter and cuter. And physically so strong as well. They know each other, these two. There's no search party, is there? They're no. Right in the middle of the ring.
No, in the boxing from the middle of the ring. Crawler tried to hunt him down last time. Didn't get many times in and out of range. Hasn't got to stay in range that often, which is where Perez can be dangerous, can pick off good shots there. But that's good there from Crawler. Nice work with the jab.
Yep, utilised that well. Perez came back looking for the body shot as well. That's good from Crawler, though. Accuracy with the jab, timing. He says he's expected a better Perez, but that he is better Crawler. From the time in the gym, that he will prove he's come on tonight. Tit for tat. Did Perez take that one? It's close, this already.
Boxing well, standing there.
There is Joe Gallagher, one of the hottest trainers in boxing at the moment, after Callum Smith's one-round demolition the other night against Rocky Fielding. Callum and all the Smith brothers here to support their man, Mr. Crawler. How's he begun for you?
Yeah, he's begun pretty well. Certainly won the first round for me, Perez the second. But there's nothing in it at the minute.
The silver and black of Darlis Perez, the 32-year-old from Colombia in fight number 35. And the white, gold and purple of Anthony Crawler from New Moston in Manchester. And I don't think it's just about the last year where people have warmed to him. I think it's been his story. He's had to overcome hurdles and bumps and people sort of dismissing him when he lost to Derry Matthews. He's come right back. Yeah, that great win over John Murray. People love an underdog that comes through, don't they?
Yeah, he's come through, you know what? But he's always come through as well with a smile. Such a pleasant, nice man outside of the ring. You know, and I think people, you can't help but warm to him, can you?
Yeah, he's a smashing chap, he really is. I was talking to his good lady Fran at the weigh-in, and there's obviously nerves in the family, but she's ringside tonight. And we'll be watching as intensely as Anthony is concentrating. Whereas for Perez, he has four kids back in Colombia. He said they're mouths to feed. I need to keep this world title and keep earning big. But it's about a revenge thing as well for him, I think, Perez. I think he felt he let himself and his team down a bit last time.
Yeah, I think he didn't get off to such a great start. He was countering a little bit too much. He's looking to be a little more dominant as he's come out here, but he's still a little bit loose. The hands are down, there's gaps there.
Trying to work the body, get that left hand moving. Perez, certainly more confident, more poised about him, but he is taking the odd risk as well.
Yeah, he's making mistakes as he comes forward. He's not landing with anything.
Body shots from Crawler, good defense as well from the Manchester man. Digging in the uppercuts, Perez. This is going to be a really grueling one, you sense already. It's been laid out. We're only in the third round. The pace is going to be white hot.
No, good defensive work from Crawler there. Been a little open.